Welcome to the aftermarket report with Vegas and Jim. Today's date, January 21st, 2020. And Miss Vegas has a great watch list for us.
Yes, good afternoon, everyone. So we are going to be talking about Tesla, Beyond Meats, NIO, and Boeing. So let's get right to the chase here. So first of all, I do want to mention here, make sure you follow and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Look at this. One of our YouTube subscribers, who happens to be in our chat room as well, but he's not in here all day, he said that our YouTube videos helped him this weekend. And it's been, I can't believe this, the best trading of his career. He made $57,000 today between Tesla, Beyond Meats, and then he traded JMIA and Amazon. So hats off to Mr. Consulting USA, and congratulations, and thank you so much for following and subscribing. And so if you're watching, please hit that and smash the bell to get the video updates, because we do them to help you. So let's talk about Tesla. So you could see today that Tesla had a beautiful run. And we see here at the open earlier today, you know, Tesla's previous close was 510.50, and it was, you know, practically, you know, crucified last week. And look what happened today. Went all the way up to 548.58 and opened around 530. Low of the day was about 528.41. And you know what? Tesla's still doing great. I mean, look, 549.03 after hours. So, I mean, it's even made a higher high here. So, Jim, let's hear about what we're going to see about Tesla, because, you know, this Tesla is just nonstop. I mean, it has its days where it's not a good day to trade it, except, you know, if you want to short it. And then, you know, to short this is very dangerous, because if you were to short this and swing trade it overnight, you would have been really burned this weekend. And we see that the target was raised by New Street Research to $800. Bernstein mentioned a perform rating of 325. And another analyst said that also they don't think it's going to be outperforming. So we'll see, Jim. And also there is a petition from Tesla regarding the comments about unintended acceleration in the Tesla vehicles. They are petitioning that, and they said it's completely false. So, Jim, let me hear what you got to say about Tesla, because I want to hear about what's going on.
Well, we definitely like Tesla, as we talk about it all the time. She did kind of, right out of the gate this morning, did have that breakout. I mean, we had them three big white soldiers come in here, and she broke out. And I'm going to put this little trend line right here just to kind of follow it. This is the 20-day, one-hour chart. So we're going to just kind of bring it up just to the day and just kind of talk about what happened today. So last night she dipped on down under 500 bucks, which I talked about that in the video. I said anything under that 500 would be a strong buy. And then we hit that 498.88. And then boom, here you go. Right out of the gate, she popped up, found a little resistance level, created an ascending triangle, and then had that breakout here into after hours. So the new high going to have to break out here is going to be that 849.78. I'd say the low support that needs to hold needs to be right around this 540 area. Anything below that, it could take a pretty good little dive on down to around 532. Let me put it right in here, 532.86. And the resistance that we need to break is going to be this 549.68 area. So a little support, 540. Resistance to break, 549. And good job on Tesla today. The next we're going to talk about is going to be BYND.
Well, Beyond Meats, again, this is just one of those ones here, you know, that they're going to be expanding into China. And the other thing, too, with Beyond Meats, this is, again, heavily, heavily shorted. And we know that there's going to be a short squeeze coming here. Credit Suisse did give a maintain a neutral to 125. Also, we see that they have what they call a patty-less burger. And, you know, this stock just keeps going. I mean, you know, they're going to, they have Impossible Whopper joining also 2 for $6, which is, don't forget, the BYND Beyond Meats from Burger King. So, you know, this is heavily shorted, and we keep seeing that, you know, it looks like it wants to keep going. A lot of strength in this stock, and I actually charted this. And don't forget, you know, Beyond Meat, we mentioned last time that they also have a trial with McDonald's right now for what they call their PLT sandwich, with the plant, lettuce, and tomato, featuring a Beyond Meat's pea-based patty. So we have to find out, how is that test going? We should be getting an update from McDonald's very soon. This is going to be a trial. At my understanding, I think it was for a 6-week trial. And we'll see if they can be a good supplier, and if McDonald's sales are actually doing well. So Beyond Meat is just fabulous. I actually think this can go a lot higher to 135, 143, and 150s. So it's going to take some time. But right now, I can say that we're doing very well with the option calls on this one. And everyone's been making a lot of money today on this one in particular. Jim, let's hear about this Beyond Meat. What can we see beyond this price?
Well, this is another beautiful one that's had a great run. We recognized it with a little bit of help from Miss Vegas and Trend Spider. So Beyond Meat, I was kind of at the threshold of where I was just about ready to throw it in the trash. And right about the time you start thinking like that, that's about the time it started breaking out. So we've had a 2-week breakout on this stock. It did have a yearly high of $239.71 and a yearly low of $45. So we kind of hovered around here in this below 80 area, above the $70 kind of channel. And then she kind of just broke out of that. Then we've had a double top here. Today we had another great run on it. So let's pull up the 20-day chart. Look at the 20-day. And see how we kind of broke past that resistance line, which I said in the room today was 125.25. And we did break beyond that. And after hours, we even got a high. And we'll pull that up here in a second. But on the 20-day, we was at 135.23. So that's kind of got to be our paper target, 135.23. That's where we want to head to. But for right now, the next resistance we got to break is going to be this 129.83. And after hours, we're at 128.60. So let's pull this up to the daily 1 minute. Low support is going to be, like I said, right down in this area here, 107 something. But what a beautiful run today on BYND. Resistance to break is going to be this 120, 131. Oh, let's go 65 area. Support level is going to be this previous high we had in today. And it's right here at 127.83. That's going to be your first support, 127.83. With maybe this 200 going to be your moving average support if it, on a daily 1 minute. Or it could pull back to this lower part down here right around the 122.33. That's going to be your strong support level. Then we had that ascending triangle that happened right here, and we're going to put a trend line right there and make that the low at 118.88. We'll turn that into a red line. Right there. Bam. That's going to be my third low strong buy support. My second one's going to be this 125.25, and that first one's going to be right here at the 127.83. Resistance to break 131.65, and the next one's going to be NIO, Miss Vegas.
You know what, NIO, you know, this was mentioned again in our video yesterday to help you guys prepare for the market. So, I mean, if you did listen to the video, you would know I did mention that this is a continuation is what we're looking for, and that you could actually just day trade the stock. You don't have to swing it, because a lot of people are a little hesitant to swing something where there's a lot of cash burn, afraid of, you know, offerings and things like that. So I can totally appreciate that. So if you did even listen to the video and just day traded this, I mean, it opened around 460, had a low of 452, went as high as 529. Even after hours, we're at 515. So another great call. Definitely, I also posted, if you follow us on StockTwits or on Twitter, you would have definitely seen our NIO call alert. We gave a NIO option call $5 strike gave those around 20 cents, and those went up over 100%. They went as high as 44. So, you know, they're really good opportunities to make sure you follow us on our social media, because again, I mean, I can't really give alerts in videos that where their moves already happened. So please check us out on our StockTwits and Twitter. I do post alerts when possible to help traders. And great if you did see it and bank on it. So, I mean, that's been a great move. And again, you know, this catalyst with the $1 billion investor. So Jim, what else can we maybe see on NIO? Because it's actually holding really nicely over this $5 mark.
Well, we definitely seen an ascending triangle breakout. And with your guidance on the momentum, she did go ahead and break out of that last Friday. Or the last trading session, yeah, last Friday. Or was it yesterday? Well, last Friday. So she did kind of had a breakout today. She ran up and broke past that $5. We had a 518 target with a long resistance of 554. So that's what we're looking for next. Pullback support is going to be the top of this trend line right here. And that's going to be right around the 448 for a solid low support. That's what we got to see hold. And you got your other two right here. You got the 468. The 487, and the resistance to break is going to be that 534 to 554, and that's NIO. And the next one we're going to talk about is going to be Boeing.
Well, you know, Boeing is interesting stock, so I do want to talk about it. Jim can show you guys, you know, we knew about the news and the and everything going on behind the scenes with Boeing, and there was a lot of activity happening on the, you know, Friday, and so we actually did alert a straddle play where you take one call and one put because you're not really sure how will this open come Tuesday. So I did give a straddle play on Boeing, and you could see here, Jim can show it to you. We took the 340 calls, which were $52, and we took also the $300 puts, which were at the time $33. So, you know, your total investment on this was about $85. So, you know what, if you're going to trade that and make $85 investment, well, you know what, this paid for you, because even today at the open, I mean, those actual puts had pulled back, you know, down to like $13 from 33. And you're thinking, oh my God, what a horrible swing trade, or wow, this put's not working out. And even the call was kind of a bit flat. And then all of a sudden we had news on Boeing that they're going to delay the 737 MAX being going back in the air. And then next thing you know, the puts started to run super heavy. And Jim can show you there in that picture, you see it went as high as 375. So a $33 investment went up to 375. Obviously a lot of people sold around $200, $300. Some people sold at $100. You know, it doesn't matter what they, what, you know, what your goal is. I mean, what someone else's goal is, it matters what you want. You know, if you're happy with, you know, from $33, it went up 100%, you take your money and you're happy, good for you. You know, if you know it's still running and it's a winning trade right now, you just follow the trend line and exit. You know, and Jim gave you guys this on the video. He talked about the low support on Boeing, that if it breaks 320, this is going to 310. And you know what? He nailed that. So if you see Mr. Sir Rob here in our room, he said, thanks, I sold my BA puts from 300 to, from 30 cents. He sold his at 250. So congratulations to him, and congratulations to many people that swing traded this. And you know what? We've got to watch Boeing still, because it's kind of looking bullish to me again. And looked like it was reversing from the lows of the day. So Jim, what are we going to hear about Boeing?
Very good trade today. Well, yeah, you seen what happened there when we got the news on Friday about us knowing it was going to go ahead and be a put call. And then it kind of hustled around this morning pre-market and had a high up there right around 326. We had a little running bet. I don't know where that went. I had 328. I missed it. So she went ahead, and then we got that news, and then bam, about midday, and nothing but just the red all the way down past that 310 area. This is a 20-day chart, so let's pull up the daily. Target's going to be down here at 303.17 for a low support. And then that second one's going to be right here at 307.36. That's what we got to see hold. And then the resistance to break is going to be right in this area, right around the 313. I'm going to bring it down just a little bit. 313.29 area. Bring it just up right about, yeah, right about there. 313.40. So we need to break that resistance. And that's a pretty big climb. Low support, 303. Resistance to break is going to be that 313.40, and if we can go ahead and break that, we'll bring it on up here to around 315. And that should be probably the spread you're going to see tomorrow. This is going to be Boeing, and that's it for the market report. Anything else, Miss Vegas?
Okay. Well, you know what? I just figured we stick to four stocks, and I'm probably going to look to put a little list later on tonight with a couple picks, you know, that are under the $10 that you guys can be watching for. So please make sure you follow and subscribe to YouTube and StockTwits so that you can see this list that I'm going to work on and post. And I'll put it out either later tonight or first thing tomorrow morning before the market opens, so that you can see, you know, some picks to watch for potential follow through and continuation. And happy to see that a lot of you went to the website, ilovestocks.com. You've registered to get onto the newsletter that we're going to start sending on Sunday. So please, if you haven't had a chance, visit the website and just put your email in there, and then you'll get an email confirmation, and you'll need to confirm that you want to actually get on this list, and it's a free watch list. So look forward to producing that content for you. And we hope that everyone has a great trading day tomorrow. And let's keep finding some great setups and continuing to trade green. Jim, anything else to add for today?
No, yeah, that's it. And we'll catch you tomorrow.
All right, everyone. Have a great night.
Today's date, January 21st, 2020. We love stocks. ¶¶